My name is Alfred White.
For you?
You call me Alf. Alf? This evening we are going to be sucked into the world of national service in the 1950s. I was called for national service myself. And along with me, there were many other gentlemen called up. Tonight's memories of national service are going to be brought to life. And we hope that you feel that you are part of the memories. To get a feel of what these people were going through and what they felt at the time of being called up and throughout their time away. Now, if you would all like to follow me, I shall lead you over here to where the first memories of all
from Rimmelsworth, 246-7107, RAF.
Jordan Armstrong, 6'9", 4'2", 9'5".
Rob Kidd, 5'08" or 7'4", 2". Oh, yeah.
David Peston, 1889, lineman, second class.
Eric Harrison, 315, 6'5".
Seem like the best couple of times, and we have our differences, but wherever I go, I'm going to miss you, and we'll always be.
Oh, look at this skater. You can't have them going in. I think I'm cruel. Come on, get up. Oh, do you have to go?
The call-up's here. Same level, the same hole at the same time. We call this
Straight legs, Callum, not bend.
Now, commonly after drills, all the different regiments used to meet in the Naffy. Now, the Naffy was a place where you could socialise. This is how we made a lot of our friends. We would have someone where they ate to drink.
Girls, have you seen these? I was just waiting for the lads to send off. They're lovely. They're nice and the lads got too hot. Oh, look at this one. Oh, I'd love for someone to send me one like that. It's not for you, but that's all the gorgeous. That one, I like that one. Have you ever seen that anywhere? No, not in a while anyway. I'm not sure I'm fine. Maybe around you. Maybe busy. I hope so. Maybe I'll get one of these fancy postcards.
From the army camp. It's a cold night, and the coldest we've had in years. And there's never enough firewood to keep them warm. So one soldier snuck in with his scarf in the cabin and took his furniture and burned it on the fire. He listened, you might see some of the stories.
But
I'm going to have to learn it, but he's on his
cape's gone missing. You can't get the cape. I've got inspection one morning and I can't find it anywhere. What am I going to do? So I'm going to have to buy another one. If I have to buy another one, then I'm going to have money to go out next week with you guys. Man.
So what are you going to do?
No idea. I'll lend yours.
Well, we have inspections as well.
Yeah. We can leave it over there.
No, it's too far.
Yeah.
Richard, and this is you, Pierre. You made a cake at a party the other day. She seemed to really enjoy it. She said she wanted to make Daddy a cake for when he came home.
She missed the bedtime stories of you. My imagination is as good as yours. So I often read the books your sister gave her for Christmas. She was also asking after you. We miss you so much. It's strange not having you around in the house. But darling, the sandwiches for the party won't make themselves, so I'll have to close them now. I'll hear from you soon. Stay safe. Follow Penny and Lucy.
Like, really, that would be like, what were some of them saying? Oh, so. Kind of come back.
So there we are. When we start this journey, we were a little unsure. Even our friends and family at home. All the friends I made, cutters of sorts, experiences that I shared with some of the greatest men I've ever known with.
Voice over, 60 seconds of voice over, blah, 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 blah. Any ad-libbing, or are we just going to ignore instruction?
She couldn't be in there.
Still in contact today.
Wish I could go back. Best time of my life.
Swimming over those shark nets.
I remember the sting of the sun.
Friends by your side, hiding your hand. Look. I get cigarettes. That's all you need.
How far I get to see you? Yeah. Hot weather was lovely.
Cyprus. Best tan I've ever had.
Single bites and leaves, Lord. It's going to be just as hard as seeing by my family back home.
See you later, lads.
Keep in touch.